Welcome to today's edition of 3 Minute Halacha. How many people need to be attentive in answering Amen in order for the Shaliach Tzibur, the Chazan, to begin his repetition of the Shmoneh Esrei? Specifically, if we have a minyan of just 10 people, and let's say 3 or 4 of them are still saying Shmoneh Esrei, can the Chazan begin his repetition knowing that only part of the minyan is able to answer Amen? The answer is found in a famous seeming contradiction between 2 separate chapters in the Shulchan Aruch. In Siman Nun Hei 55, the Shulchan Aruch says that when it comes to questions of Dvarim Shebekdusha, those aspects of davening that require a minyan, even if some people are still davening and unable to answer, some people are asleep and unable to answer, or even a person who is deaf and can't hear in order to answer, as long as there are 10 people present, it's considered as if there's a minyan. Whereas in Siman Kuf Chaf Dalet 124, we learn that if a person is not responding to the Shmoneh Esrei, if there aren't at least the 9 people responding, the Rosh teaches us that it's karov, that it's very close to being a bracha levatala, a transgression. What is the halacha? According to the Shulchan Aruch HaRav, these 2 chapters describe 2 different things. The first chapter talks about Kaddish and Baruch Hu, whereas the second chapter talks about the Chazarat HaShatz, the Shmoneh Esrei, the repetition. The first chapter, therefore, means that when you want to say Kaddish, you want to say Kedusha, you want to say Baruch Hu, even if you have people who are not able to answer, as long as 10 people are present, you can do so. Second chapter, however, when it comes to the repetition, you need a full minyan responding. You need 9 people plus the Chazan fully attentive. Whereas the Magen Avraham disagrees, and he says, no, the difference between these 2 chapters are lechatchila and b'dieved, are a question of an ideal. Ideally, you need to have 9 plus 1 fully attentive. However, if you don't, if there are extenuating circumstances, someone is asleep, some people are still davening, it doesn't preclude us from beginning the repetition. Ultimately, the halacha is that when there are extenuating circumstances, when there are time considerations, when a minyan may leave, we are allowed to begin Chazarat HaShatz, even if there are still some people davening, even if we don't have 9 people able to answer. The Tzitz Eliezer talks about the classic case of the majority. 5 people able to answer plus the Chazan, that's 6, which means there's still 4 people davening Shmoneh Esrei. However, the Yalkut Yosef, the current chief rabbi of Israel, Rabbi Yitzchak Yosef, rules that you should have a minyan nikar, that at least you have 6 people who have finished, plus the Chazan for a total of 7, and you shouldn't start unless there are 3 or fewer people left to finish their Shmoneh Esrei. Ultimately, the halacha and the custom is that we will begin Chazarat HaShatz even if the entire minyan is unable to respond, as long as we have 6 or 7 people total who will be attentive.